10:34 on this 15th day of March. Lisa Webb, Third Street Realty, on the show now. How are we doing, Lisa?
Doing great. Doing great.
I am so sorry.
That's okay. That's okay. You know, we're all human, and it gives us something to laugh about. So it's a good icebreaker.
There
right?
you go. Well, they just love it because the text line loves it when I get to mess something up, you know? And so I'm sure my phone will ding about 10 times during this conversation.
Yeah, exactly.
So I think this is so cool that you're joining us today. And just to break the ice even further, we've had an interesting couple of conversations. And you're in studio now. That's all that matters. So how long have you been with Third Street Realty? Now, are you the founder? Did you start this?
I am. Yeah,
that's so
absolutely.
Cool.
Yeah. So I've been in real estate going on 8 years now. And at the end of 2021, for some reason, we thought right at Christmas time would be great to start a new business. So yay, here we are. So we're at a year old now.
Wow.
And so Third Street Realty is a woman-owned business. So I am the owner designated managing broker, mm-hmm. But we're family run. So my husband, he also has a side of real estate that he does. And so we just been in the real estate industry for years, and it's what we do in our family. The name is people always ask, well, that's a pretty general name. And what's really neat about it is I tried to think, what am I going to name our company that's going to have some meaning? It could be all kinds of things. So, you know, when you're doing your best thinking whenever you're in the shower, you're like, yeah, that's it. So I was raised on Third Street in Livingston. My husband was raised on Third Street in Cottage Hills. We purchased our first home on Third Street. So all of the stars aligned. And then here I am today, right off Third Street.
Well, you're right. That's actually super cool. Because I always ask people, I go, you know, what? Give us the meaning behind, you know, the name or the meaning behind why you did this. And sometimes we get some insightful ones, but sometimes they're generic. This is my favorite. That is my absolute favorite.
Yeah.
So in this year process, or your journey now with Third Street Realty, what has been kind of the highlights of that year? Have you had a lot of great feedback, a lot of good success?
Have. Yeah, we have. So we're what you would call a small business, mom and pop.
Yeah.
We're not a franchise. Just like the small business owners, everything that we do for our clients, that results in putting food on our table.
Yep.
So we sort of bring that into our values with our company. We do have two branch locations. Mm-hmm. So my main office is in Bunker Hill. So we're really plugging Bunker Hill this week because we had somebody from Bunker Hill yesterday.
Yep.
So my main office, though, is in Bunker Hill. That's where my husband and I moved to. Not on Third Street, but that's okay. And I do have another office in Edwardsville. So we cover anywhere from Springfield, Illinois, all the way down to Waterloo and everywhere in between. So it makes it nice to service the northern clients up by, you know, Springfield with Bunker Hill and then our southern in Edwardsville. So
that's incredible. I mean, that is really incredible. And another thing I think you guys do really well is your guys' social media presence with some informational graphics and just all these different charts. And was that something pretty big on your guys' radar right off the bat, was making sure you're connected?
Yeah, because as you know, in the industry, video presence on social media, things have changed in the last 8 years since I even started in real estate. And so now there's so much going on out there in the social media world that we have to really, especially to compete with the bigger companies, we have to really get out there and be in front of your face, if you will, you know, and it's a lot of work, you know, but it's okay. It takes me a lot to get to that. It's way out of my comfort zone, but hey, here I am.
That I'm right there with you. I used to just, you know, microphone on, you're good to go, you know? And now I scare people every morning, you know?
I feel that way too. Like, no, I'm not going to do that. Oh my. no worries.
So take us through this. So do you guys, I'm sure you guys have a plethora of different clients and different backgrounds, different demographics, but what, my first question is going to be for you is, you know, experience with first-time home buying, because I've seen so many, you know, courses going on and so many different programs. Can you take us through what your experience is with that first-time home buyer, how you guide them on those steps?
So with Third Street Realty, really key is education.
Okay.
Because there is a lot of steps that go into when you purchase a home for the first time. There's a lot of different lending options, a lot of grant programs. There's a lot of things that that buyer has to really understand before they take that first step, because mm-hmm. it can be very overwhelming. You come to a closing and we say, well, you need to have about $2,000 more than what you thought you did. And that does happen. So education is key.
Yeah.
So Third Street, we really like to focus on education more so than, like I like to say, we won't tell you what you want to hear.
Yeah.
We will educate you on what you need to know. So when we go through those steps, just because you're approved for $1 million house, I'm not going to push that. If you,
thank you.
Really cannot afford,
thank you.
You're not going to get it.
Well, and Lisa, I'll be honest with you. I did the stupid thing, and I went on Zillow.
No!
And I did, hold on. I know. It's like scratching the chalkboard, you know? So I go on Zillow, and this is all I did. I said, well, you know, I'm just curious to see what is, because I'm not acting, you know, I wasn't actively looking, but I'm going, well, let's just see if there's anything on there. So I go on Zillow. I swear to you, the next day, I was approved for $100,000, $200,000. It was ridiculous. And now, recently, I actually did get legitimately approved, so that's great to hear. But the amount of people that take advantage of folks that are mm-hmm. just on that app, I mean, I think that's kind of dangerous almost.
Yeah, absolutely. And we do like to stress to our clients, keep it local.
Yeah.
Go with a local lender. Go with local home inspectors.
Yep.
Go with all those local people who understand the community and the different rules and regulations, because if you get somebody that's from out of state, they can't use a lot of our grants,
yes.
like the Madison County grant and things like that. So,
well, and that's such a great point. And that's, it's so funny you say that, because I'm sitting there talking to this guy, because I'm new to this. So I'm like, oh yeah, talk to this guy, thinking, oh, he's local. Turns out a guy's in Michigan in his office. And so finally got connected to a local person, streamlined the process. Cool. Mm-hmm. But what I think is really interesting is a lot of people have a debate right now, Lisa, about, is it better as a, you know, if you're just, you know, getting your feet wet, you just got started that career job, mm-hmm. is it better to rent or is it better to buy? And to me, I think I can't answer that question,
but
maybe you can.
So when you look at renting, the cost, just like the value of your home goes up, so does the rent.
Yeah.
So when you're starting off, when you go to rent, they're going to run your credit. They're going to run your background. If you qualify for a nice rental, chances are you're going to qualify for a nice small home. Nobody says you have to go crazy.
Right.
Just get yourself a nice solid home. It's an investment. It's an asset. So why would you not want to go that route? Plus it's yours.
Exactly.
You want to paint the walls green and purple? You can do it. If you want to have 500 cats, you can do it. You
Please
know?
Don't.
Yeah, don't do that for resale value. Let me backtrack that.
Well, you know,
so.
So another thing that I think is really important too in the process of selling or buying, not really mm-hmm. selling, is, you know, making sure that all the checks are done. Mm-hmm. I haven't told many people this, but for a few years I was helping my uncle and my family's business, Rigdon Sewer Service, and going in and a lot of houses being sold. And
oh, sure.
We go in and we got to check the lines. And mm-hmm. I kept telling folks, I said, make sure, and this, I don't know what the regulation is now, but 3 years ago I had a buddy buying a house. I said, did you check that sewer?
Yeah.
Oh, no, we don't need to.
Yeah.
I would check that sewer because that's clay.
$10,000 later, you wish you would have.
Exactly. How many things like that do you guys mm-hmm. experience where you're maybe at a closing and, you know, I'm sure you guys dot your T's and cross your I's, but mm-hmm. there could always be, I guess, something that comes up that mm-hmm. wasn't discussed initially.
Yeah, absolutely. So that is one of the things that the agents in our brokerage, we are a number one fan of home inspectors.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of the home inspectors that we use, they're telling it like it is. But what we do at Third Street is we also want to make sure that we're with our clients when this process is being explained.
Mm-hmm.
Because we need to bring people off the ledge sometimes because they're like, oh my gosh, my house is falling in. No, not really.
But right.
But they need to know that up front. Is it going to be a deal breaker? Not necessarily. We can walk through it Because the worst feeling in the world is when you go to close on your house and you didn't do that sewer inspection, and now you have to do $10,000 worth of sewer replacement, especially on Orangeburg or something like that. Oh. Then, you know, we should have had those conversations. Yep. So we really, it's all about the education.
You're right. And you're absolutely right. And by the way, with Orangeburg, just dig it up. We've only
just dig it up. No, but dig it up.
We would sit there for hours and try to get through Orangeburg. And every once in a while, you can get through the roots.
Yeah.
Dig it up. Anyway, so Lisa, with this in this year, what's been the best part of this journey with the family with Third Street Realty?
Well, so besides having it your own and really taking ownership and representing your clients the way they should be, which was one of the reasons that we got into this was, you know, to represent the way they should. We do a little niche that we have with Third Street is I do a lot of foreclosures. So it's not the dreamy side of real estate. It's the more scary and sad side. People don't realize there's a sad side. There is a sad side to real estate. So what I started doing at the beginning of the year is I partnered with Blueprint Short Sales. And there's agents with us all across the United States. And we partnered together to do short sales for our local communities.
Wow.
So we try to educate. Our goal for the mission for the Blueprint Short Sales is to help 100,000 families this year. Wow. So the goal of that, though, is to educate again and help people before it's too late with selling their home. I've had to do evictions. I've had to do cash for keys. I would love to help somebody do a sale of their home before I have to come and knock on that door for the bad part.
Yeah.
So that's sort of where our heart is right now, just trying to educate people and help those in need and not knowing where to go.
Well, and to me, that is, you can't put a price tag on that.
No.
And I think so many times, you know, you see all these, you know, a gauntlet of real estate agents and all, but very rarely do they actually want to educate, it seems like. A lot of it's just, let's get you in, let's get you out, let's get that rolling, let's sign this, let's sign that.
Yeah.
It seems like you guys really like to take this step by step and really, I hate to say hold the hand of a client.
No, that's absolutely correct.
But that's kind of what I was
getting at. We'll walk you through it, we'll hold your hand, we'll ask questions. The best feeling in the world is when you go to a closing and somebody starts to cry because they're
Does that happen a lot?
It does. Yeah. Especially your young buyers, you know, or the people that are like, I've been renting all my life. I did not know that I could buy a house and now it's theirs. And, you know, that's what it's all about. It's about helping the individual.
I am a fan of yours, Lisa Webb. I am telling you what, you are so genuine. And that's what I think is such a great asset in a real estate agent, too, is because, you know, like, I hate to say this, but I've heard it before. I used to do real estate segments somewhere else or be a part, not do them, but I ran the boards and lots of conversations. And so, you know, you hear them and it's like sometimes people look at real estate agents like, you know, the car salespeople. But there's folks just like you out there that are really there to be that that hand and that shoulder. And I got a question. I keep hearing about interest rates. Every day I hear about interest rates. Every day. It's exhausting. It's like I run a marathon.
It is, yeah.
And now, so to me, what my thought process, my thought is, and I don't, like I said, I don't know. I'm asking the expert. With Third Street Realty, I want to know, even though interest rates are going up, they're still reasonably lower than what they used to be, right?
They are. So yes, when I started, our interest rates were where they are at now. And that was 8 years ago. And then for some reason, we had this drop in interest rates with all the feds and everything. And oh my gosh, it was just a nightmare all across the board, you know, because people were refinancing, people were wanting to, you know, get into a loan. And that is not normal. Now, again, my disclosure is I'm not an attorney, I'm not a lender, so always consult those professionals. But back in the day, like whenever I first bought my first house back in 1991, I was at a 12 and a 13%. Some of our parents and our grandparents were at 18 to 20. So the consumers nowadays are like, oh my gosh, the interest rate is at 6%. It's at 6.25. that's okay.
Yeah.
It is. It's still okay. You're still better than what it was back in 2007, 2008. And so they, what? How do they say it? Let's see. Now I'm not going to get it right. Marry the house, divorce the rate, or something like that. Don't wait around for the interest rates to go back down, because chances are they're not.
That's very, thank you, because so many times I hear, you know, so many different comments about this, and it's like, you know, let's just be real about it, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. If you're that person that's going to just sit around and wait and wait and wait, well, chances are you're going to be waiting for a while, and then you're going to miss out. And why? Life's too short.
Yeah.
So don't do that.
You know, like I said, you guys do such a good job of education. And on your social media, if you guys haven't, just if you're on your, if you're on watching on riverbender.com from the website, you'll notice my botch, and it's Third Street Realty, and we'll move on. But listen, things happen, mistakes were made, but the fun is being had now. You can type in facebook.com/Third Street Realty, or if you're on the app, just go over to Third Street Realty on Facebook, because this is a gauntlet of information. Now, in terms of locally here, do we have any properties we want to talk about today?
Well, I have properties that are all over. So I have some acreage in Bunker Hill, and I have an investment home over in Staunton, and I have a property in Belleville, and a couple in East St. Louis. And I have a variety of properties that absolutely go to thirdstreetrealty.com, visit our website. You'll see everything that's available out there. It's not something that I wanted to just really touch bases on today.
Yeah.
But it is there. So if you visit our website, you can definitely go there and see what we have to offer as far as listings. But we can do buyers as well. So don't think that, you know, if you're looking for a home, we only do listings. We have, you know, we have three agents total with Third Street.
Okay.
Hoping to grow more. So anybody out there looking, we are looking for agents like-minded like us.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, we do have great buyer's agents as well with the same mindset.
So. Well, and that's what I was wondering, because I didn't know if you guys specialized in that buying or selling process. Mm-hmm. So you guys have it all covered across the board.
Yes, we have it all covered. I have an agent that really specializes in multifamilies. I have another agent that has done commercial real estate certification. So we have a variety of different avenues that we can touch base on. But our main focus and our main mission is just making sure that each person is treated just like our family, you know, with the respect they deserve. So, but we got you covered.
Absolutely. And I think it is so important to have that. And I wanted to ask you now, I was on your website yesterday. I noted a couple of blog postings, some advice. Now, do you guys have like mail or some type of sign up sheet that we can get some of your information on a consistent basis?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure. If you go, you can log in, and I'm not prepared to really dive down where you need to go with that, but I can do that.
Oh, right here.
There you go.
Log in. All you do is go to thirdstreet.com or thirdstreetrealty.com, and it says register. Log in.
There you go.
Put your full name, put your email.
You heard it from CJ first.
Come on. That's simple. But see, that's what I love about this. It's not where I have to go search it, and you and I are kind of stumbling for a couple of minutes while it's everything
right
on your website is seriously, it's perfect, because you aren't hiding anything. It's right there for all of us to see. And what are some of the other things that you guys do at Third Street that you'd like to highlight in this first time we're talking?
So one thing I did want to mention that I did bring for you today, leave it, is I do have a guide to...
Can I see one of
those?
Yes,
you may. A complete guide to selling your home as a short sale. Mm-hmm. So this is a lot of question and answers. And it is an ideal book to help somebody get through a process if they don't feel comfortable enough yet to pick up the phone and call me. Because it is. People are embarrassed. It's a hard phone call to make.
Mm-hmm.
So I do have this available. This can be emailed out digitally, or I can mail it. And it, again, is the complete guide to selling your home as a short sale. It'll take you from beginning to end.
Well, this is not just, and because I'm not going to lie, when we talked about it on the phone yesterday, I thought, well, maybe a couple of pages.
Mm-mm,
this is 12 chapters. And to me, this is what, to me, is the, it's not a selling point. It's why if I was buying tomorrow or buying today, I'd be giving you a call.
Right.
Because this isn't, you know, information on why you should use us and nobody else. This is just actual information that you guys are providing to all of us to help this process. Because like you said, I can only imagine being on the other end of this phone call, what that conversation's like.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, can I ask you, has there been a time where, you know, you first start with short selling that you're going, man, I don't know if I can, you know, do, because it takes a special person to handle these situations.
It does. And it's not, short sale is misleading because it's not short.
Yeah.
It can take a long time to get through a process when you're going through a short sale. So, but what really helped me understand where I want to go into the short sale is because of the foreclosures that I've done.
Gotcha.
So right before Christmas time, in the middle of the cold weather, I had two clients that were in homes that were foreclosed, and we had to do cash for keys for them. And the one lady, when I went there, she didn't even have a working furnace. She was heating her house by a stove. And I was able to give her money to move out, hand me the keys, and continue the foreclosure process. Mm-hmm. So originally my background is healthcare.
Is it really?
Corporate America,
okay.
Way back when. And in the healthcare field, a lot of it was home health and hospice. Mm-hmm. So that compassion, you need to have that. You need to have that understanding. Husband and I have been together, married 32 years.
Congratulations.
Thank you. We've had a lot of ups and downs in our life.
Right.
So what we have felt and had to do in our history and past is what takes us forward to help other people.
This is just incredible. I mean, you are just incredible. This is great. And by the way, let me break the ice by saying, well, now that we got a lot of the bulk of this conversation out of the way, I called Lisa yesterday and I said, Miss Lisa, I have you booked on the schedule. I've had you booked there for 3 weeks, but I don't think you ever got an email saying that you're welcome on this show.
You didn't want me.
And, you know, and the thing is, though, Lisa, you could have easily said, the F are you doing calling me a day before this thing, you know, and you could have chewed me out and hung up the phone and I would have understood because it happens, you know,
yeah.
But you didn't. You have a great personality. You're so easy to work with and talk to. And that's what I think we all want in that real estate process, whether we're buying, whether we're selling, whether we're going through the unfortunate situation of a foreclosure. And now I do have a question for you. During the pandemic, were foreclosures rates a lot higher?
Well, so the COVID issue, which, COVID, but, you know, yes, things were shut down. So you were, the eviction stopped, everything halted, and people just stayed in their home. When things started to open up, I did do several foreclosures where the occupant was still in the house.
Okay.
And people bought it with the person inside, then they had to handle the evictions. But things are starting to open back up. Again, my disclaimer, I'm not an attorney. However, do we foresee the sky falling again? No, we do not. We all of the professionals are reporting you're not going to see a repeat of 2007, 2008. Don't hold me liable if that happens. That's my disclaimer.
They're going to play the show if it happens. They're going to play the show.
No, but all serious, it's not pointing that direction.
No, it really isn't.
So, you know, in fact, I did a few numbers before I came just on the foreclosures, and I won't get all into that for time purposes, but we are actually from January of 2022 to March of 2023, or from January 2022 to March of 2022, we are actually for 23, look, I'm getting all gumbobbled on my words. Our numbers are actually lower on closings of foreclosures currently than they were in 2022. Not by much. They had 23 in 2022 for the first 3 months and 17 now. So Things will start opening back up. We won't see a big uptick in it, but it is there. It's always there.
Right.
Because people always will have that problem.
Well, exactly. But the thing is, too, and this is what I think is, because we have a minute left, I just want to say what I think is so important about this is the educational thing is the huge takeaway. Mm-hmm. You know, if you're going to help educate us and you're going to walk us through, hold our hand, you're going to give us material to be, you know, versed in, mm-hmm. that helps prevent, I think, a lot of, you know, unfortunate situations. Not all of them, but a lot of them. And Lisa, one more time, what's your website?
So it's www.thirdstreetrealty.com.
Mm-hmm.
And they can reach us at 618-650-8787 or my cell, always available, 618-407-2513. And we're in Edwardsville or Bunker Hill.
Sounds great. Lisa, thank you so much for hanging out with me today. It is 10:59 on this 15th day of March. We're out of here, but tomorrow we're back in studio with a great show. So I hope you join me then at 9 o'clock on the dot. Have a great day, and just try your best to stay out of jail.